Now, Representative, is there some level of transparency from PAGCOR? For example, how many POGO licenses have they issued? Kasi ang nangyayari, people cannot tell ano yung legal na POGO at illegal na POGO dahil ang legal at illegal, pareho nang may ginagawang illegal.
That's correct. There's supposed to be a strict regulation by the PAGCOR. In fact, they're doing their job. So, unfortunately, may pumapasok sa atin na with the same scheme, the same personalities or perpetrators, but hindi sila registered and accredited by PAGCOR. Kaya nga the PAGCOR has actually coordinated with the law enforcement agencies to do a crackdown on these illegal POGO operators. Marami kasi silang pumapasok dito. Yun nga eh, that's the reason why maybe it's now high time to really ban this industry and put a stop to this.
Okay, but you are calling for the ban. You have some senators also calling for the ban. But has there ever been an investigation with PAGCOR? For example, do we know or do we have a record? How many POGO licenses have they issued? Like, would you know a number? I have not spoken to any lawmaker who knew a number.
Well, I remember in the last, if I'm not mistaken, budget hearing when PAGCOR was on deck. No, we were asking how many licenses of POGO were issued. If I'm not mis if I remember it correctly, less than 20. Eh? Less than 20 licenses. I hope I'm correct. No, but again, because of these less than 20 legitimate accredited POGO operators. There's still a lot of POGOs that are coming to the country. Hindi lang online gaming yung kanilang ginagawa. There's phishing, there's scamming, there's hacking, and all these illegal activities are perpetrated by these people from China. Uh, that's that's uh, that's the issue in this whole hullabaloo, Karen. Kaya nga, there must really be a strict monitoring and regulation to be done by not just PAGCOR but all law enforcement agencies.
And what's proven, no, Representative Barbers, is these POGO industries, these companies use the licenses, use the law as a cover to do other illegal businesses because
That's
they
correct.
are in a compound, right? And
That's
what
right.
I've heard is you can't just enter this compound. So, like for example, the Zunyu One technology, that had a PAGCOR license, didn't it?
Yes. I believe they have a license with PAGCOR.
Okay, and the raid, the POGO in Porac, Pampanga, did that have a PAGCOR license too? What we've heard is they also have a license.
That's correct. Mukhang merong nagduduplicate ng license. Looks like somebody else is using the same. Probably they're faking it, no? The people behind the illegitimate POGO operations are the same guys, no, that are operating the legitimate accredited PAGCOR licensed operations. So, I feel that the legit ones are using their license as fronts, but behind the scenes, they're also doing some illegal activities. Kasi they're making more money in the illegal operations more than what they make in the legitimate operations. Again, Karen, no, if you look at if you listen to the stories of the people that are quite familiar with POGO, yung mga compounds na yan, why aren't they allowing people to come and visit and check and
Exactly.
monitor, di ba? So there must be keeping something out of the public eye. And what is this? Perhaps this is the illegal operations. And exactly what happened was when we raided them, we discovered that there are scamming, hacking materials, hacking softwares that they are using. Eh, hindi naman for online gaming yun. So obviously, the reason why they're not allowing people to go and check and monitor and, you know, do an ocular inspection of the compound is because they are keeping something out of the public eye. Kaya yung sa Island Cove in Cavite, I guess dapat tinitingnan natin yan, sinisilip natin yan. Because, you know, they develop so much development in the area. And we know that they probably are keeping something out of the public eye there. So dapat we should start visiting, monitoring, and inspecting all these compounds.
Okay, because right now I'm reading from some records. It turns out, so PagCorp Chairman Al Tengco said, I don't know if this was in a hearing or in an interview, but he said that in 2023, the government earned 5.2 billion pesos from the 48 licensed POGO companies in the Philippines. So ang tanong ko, is 5.2 billion pesos, will that make a dent in the national budget if POGOs are removed?
Well, of course, we cannot deny Karen that there's any funds, though, and we cannot deny that. But if the social cost is much higher or outweighs the benefits that we can get out of this, eh, dapat pag-isipan nating mabuti. Which is what's happening now, no? With the proliferation of POGO, POGO employees, POGO operations in the country, the negative outweighs the benefits that we're getting out of this industry. So it's now high time to think twice and probably put a stop to this.
So, Representative Borbers, what do you think is stopping, what is the biggest challenge? Because former Finance Secretary Ben Diokno, he was for the banning of POGO. And just recently, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto, when asked what about the banning of POGO, he said absolutely no objection. So you have two finance secretaries that aren't even worried if POGO is banned in the Philippines. And yet, the president won't follow the economic team. So there must be a stronger hand here. Why doesn't the president just ban it if his own finance secretary is saying, no objection, ban it? Kasi hindi nga ganun kalaki naman yung pondo.
Well, I think in fairness to the president, he's probably studying some alternatives to this industry. Of course, if we take this out, there's a significant percentage of our funds that will be taken out too. So if we can replace this with some industry or some investment that would come from other sources, well, maybe it's the president would not think twice in issuing a ban or a stop to this industry. Just like what you said, two former finance secretaries has already said that they have no objections if the government decides to stop this industry. So again, I hope in the coming weeks, the president will come out with a statement on the POGO, considering that there are a lot of criminalities that have been happening, which is connected to the POGO industry. Yeah. You know, POGO employees are the ones being tortured, prostituted.
Exactly.
Some of them are even killed. You know? So I guess the problem really now is in the decision whether we should stop this or continue allowing the operations of POGO in the country.
Okay, so in this was a January 2024 interview of PagCorp Chair Al Tengco. He said, other than the 5.2 billion revenues POGO gave the government in 2023, apparently his records show there are 68,000 Filipinos who work in Pogo. So obviously there will be more Chinese nationals because the ones manning the games, right, are actually Chinese nationals because the games are in Chinese. So they you technically import Chinese nationals. Hence, the trafficking begins and it worsens. But 68,000 Filipinos are in Pogo. So maybe they serve, the receptionist, they're doing other things, but that's 68,000. What do you think of that?
Well, I really don't know about that 68,000. It seems that, yes, there are Filipinos being employed by these POGOs, but as far as the number is concerned, I don't really know whether it baka they counted also the downstream businesses no in relation to the operations of POGO. But as far as directly employing Filipinos, mas marami nga yung Chinese na ini-employ nila kaysa yung then that's the reason why we have a lot of Chinese here because they brought the Chinese here to work for their corporations.
Exactly. And the biggest problem really is there's a lack of transparency in the POGO industry. That's what's alarming, right? I mean, the fact that you can't even go into the compound, the premises, the buildings. It turns out the one in Bamban had a tunnel. There's also an illegal hospital, an illegal clinic, Chinese nationals being the doctor. It's already it's a subculture in the Philippines.
Yeah, that's correct. You know, I am wondering why they will not allow anyone to monitor and inspect, do an ocular inspection of their operations. Sabi ko nga, they're probably keeping something out of the public eye. So, bakit? Eh, siguro, illegal ito. And that's the reason why they won't allow anyone to do an ocular inspection. So, again, now, if we want this to continue, there has to be some semblance of transparency. I agree, Karen. And we should inspect if possible every day their operations and every nook and cranny of their compound must be inspected.
But Representative Barbers, isn't this already hypocritical for the government? I mean, we are allowing large-scale POGO, which includes a lot of scamming. There's prostitution, there's illegal arms, there's human trafficking. And yet, bawal ang wetting. I mean, I'm not for gambling in general, but I'm trying to say I don't understand the policy, right? I mean, I understand resorts that are out there. Soler, Resorts World, etc. It's transparent. Yeah. It's in the open, there's investment, you see the jobs, Filipinos walking in, but I don't get it. We're banning wetting, we're in tumatayan ng tagsasampung piso, nasa kalye, and then ang POGO, the government supports it.
Well, in casinos kasi, Karen, ito ay accredited by a regulating body, which is PAGCOR. And there are fees that they have to pay and a certain percentage that they make will be remitted back to the national government. Ang mga wetting o illegal gambling per se are actually illegal in the sense that they don't remit any payment to the national government. Some of the results of their gambling are rigged. Rigged results yan eh. Kaya illegal. Kaya talagang bawal yan. Now, because in our culture, hindi maalis yung some people are betting, no? And that's the reason why it must be regulated, monitored, and operations must be accredited by a regulating body. And there is a regulating or regulatory framework or policy to allow operations like this. Yung unlike yung mga illegal gambling, wala talaga yan. Hindi nagbabayad yan. Dinadaya yung resulta.
All right. So will there be any investigation on Pogo? I mean, raids are continuing right now.
Yes, we siguro we will allow.
I was going to say, I didn't mean to interrupt you. What's so worrisome? So you have, there's a question on Alice Go. She's been suspended, right? And then elections are coming up on the 25th. But then if Malacañang is listening, there's that 7 hectare, in that 7 hectare compound, there are Pogo facilities there. So what will happen? Magpapalit ang mayor, tuloy ang Pogo. But because at the end of the day, di ba Pogo corrupts the local officials too?
Well, first and foremost, I guess we should look into the regulating policy in allowing POGOs here. No, if there are violations being committed, I guess the PAGCOR has the right to terminate whatever contract they entered into with a POGO operations or POGO operator. So I guess that's one area that we should really study and look into. Second, there are fraud or fraudulent procedures that was committed by the operator. No, for instance, yung ginawa ng mayor. No, obvious na meron siyang interest doon sa corporation, and her name and her relative's name appear in the corporation that manages and owns the POGO operations, which is a direct conflict of interest as far as the local chief executive is concerned. No, parang merong question din doon. And all these things that are somehow quote-unquote illegal are enough basis for the government to terminate its contract with the POGO operators, as well as maybe conduct for future procedures or maybe forfeit all these buildings if finally it has been discovered that there is fraud that was committed.
Use the buildings for something else, transform them into classrooms. How's that? That would be good, no? Yun na lang. Refit them into classrooms or a school.
Yeah, or maybe pwedeng gawin niyang ano, pwedeng gawin niyang, if it seems to be a hotel to me.
Ah, okay.
So pwedeng gawin hotel yan that will be owned, operated, and managed by the LGU. So that they will have their economic enterprise in the locality. There are still a lot of things that we can study about how to put it in good use rather than gambling.
Oh, on that note, thank you so much for joining me today, Congressman Robert Ace Barbers. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Karen. Thank you for having me again.